Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. I was working with someone and the first thing they said that intrigued me was, hey, we can only use native queries and we're using direct query. This is what our DBAs want. And I was like, why can't they? He was like, no, Patrick, shh. That's all we can do. I'm like, okay, that's fair enough. But we want to use dynamic in parameters. I'm like, yeah, got some videos on that. Go check them out. They're like, yeah, we watch your videos, but you haven't done a video to show us how to do multi-select or select all. And I was like, oh, I haven't. Well, I'm gonna go off and do one. Wasn't easy as I thought. I had to phone some friends. I gave a call to Pat Mahoney at Hoosier BI and Mr. Alex Powers, Mr. Power Query himself. And they gave me some very insightful information that helped me produce this video. So you all know how we like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So we started with a model that looks like this. There's two tables, internet sales and sales territory. Sales territory populates the slicer that we want to use to pass values to filter this table. So how do you set up dynamic in parameters with multi-select and select all? Let me show you. So the first thing you need to do is go into Power Query, create your parameter. Then you want to use that parameter in one of your queries. So we're going to use it in our internet sales query. So we're going to go into the advanced editor. First thing we're going to do is check to see if that parameter is a list. Then just return country. If it's not, I'm going to use this little constructor here and make it a list. And then what I want to do is I'm going to paste a little code snippet in. So once I check to see if it's a list, I want to use it as the output. And so you can see here, I'm going to go through every row in this particular step and see if anything in this list is in one of my columns in that particular result set. And if it is, return it. If not, don't. So I'm going to copy this and I'm going to output this. And then I'm gonna click done and I'm gonna choose close and apply. We'll let it do its thing. And then the next thing we're gonna do is go set up dynamic in parameters. So you can see it's filtered to Canada because that's what I had the value in my parameter set to. So we're gonna head over here. We're gonna bind that parameter to the column in my slicer. So we're gonna go to advanced, bind this to country, and we're gonna turn on multi-select and select all. Okay, and you can see you get the little indicator that this is a dynamic in parameter. So we're gonna go back over here and you can see it automatically switched to Australia. But if I choose Canada, it adds Canada, France, and on and so forth. The multi-select works. And they're like, well, all right, Patrick, but we still need to select all. And I'm like, huh, hang on. Let me show you how to make that work. So if I choose select all right now, right, I get nothing. That's because if you head back over here, you can see with select all, it's returning underscore, underscore, select all, underscore, underscore. And so I need to do some checking in my M to accommodate that. So what I'm gonna do is go back over here to internet sales, go to advanced editor, add a new line right up here. And what I'm gonna say is, I'm gonna check to see if select all is in my list. So I'm gonna say if list.contains underscore underscore select all underscore underscore, then true, else false. Oh, hang on one second. Forgot my parentheses here. It's all right. There we go. So if this list contains select all, return true. Otherwise, return false. And what we're going to do is we're going to add a step. This is going to be my output. And what I'm going to do is say if is select all, then just return Power BI Internet Sales without a filter, right? Else return multi-select. And then I'm going to simply output this. Okay. Click done. Click close and apply. And so now watch what happens with select all. Boom, it returns everything. If I uncheck and just use Australia, if I use Canada, and then if I switch to select all, it returns everything. What do you think? It wasn't that difficult, just a few extra steps. Again, thanks to Pat Mahoney and Alex Powers for helping out with this. If you wanna know more about query folding or, you know, things like that, there should be a video flying above my head. If you got any questions, any comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. All right, as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.